Hello students, welcome once again. In this video we'll try to see the rise of nationalism in modern India, how the feeling of nationalism emerged in India. We'll try to see that in this video. If I say it is due to the Britishers that India would know the oppression over them, it will be very fair enough. So it is the Britishers which forced Indians to analyze the extent of their oppression over themselves with their diffused modern and cultural ideology. Introduction to modern education and numerous socio-religious reform help Indians to realize the exploitative nature of British. Basically, the English education led Indians to realize that they are being oppressed. The socio-economic changes coupled with increased oppression of the British led to new national consciousness among the people. They realized that Britishers were in India only to exploit the Indians for their benefit. We know that Britishers established themselves as a British East India Company and then they entered in the politics. So basically it was a merchant company, trading company. And all the work that they have done in India just to get more and more benefit out of it. So by the start of 19th century, Indians realized that Britishers were in India only to exploit them and they are not going to do any benefit of Indians. Industrial revolution in Great Britain had given Indian intellectual some hope of modernization in India because Great Britain was growing there. They felt that the British should treat them at par with themselves. It did not take much time for the Indians to realize the disillusionment about the real motive behind the British rule, because Britishers were not giving any respect to the Indians and they were just here to earn more and more money. So the world was progressing, the entire world was progressing through this industrial revolution. India was regressing. The economic policies of Britishers gradually led to the mass dissatisfaction amongst the people. So the British officers were busy in enjoying their lives in India, whereas Indians were dying of hunger. This is very devastating for Indian society. And there was British discrimination against Indian, which was evident by the act they passed. We have Arms Act, which did not allow Indians to manufacture and process or sell fire. The Vernacular Press Act in 1878 allowed confiscation of newspapers and the printing press by the British government. So it was a censor kind of thing. If Indian wants to publish something, it should be censored by the British officer. Only after the permission of British officers, the newspapers were allowed to print the news. And if the content was found objectionable, it was not allowed to get print. So we had Ilbert's bill proposed in 1883 that allowed Indian judges to preside the cases concerning Europeans, but there was huge rebellion by the British officers over there. against the bill, and the bill was then amended, and it was decided that the no Indian judge could preside over the cases concerning with the Europeans. After all this coexistence of the people in India, along with modernization and the percolation of the modern education into the society, coupled with the sweeping current of westernization, the feeling of nationalism developed in Indians. And then we had the revolutionists like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Mohandas Mohan Ranade. So I hope that you could analyze the society in early 19th century in India, and you could see the rise of nationalism in India. That's it in this lecture. See you for early associations in the next period. Thank you.